Yes, I've already agreed it was fishy, Harry. But haven't we agreed there could be a lot of explanations? Maybe he's broken his hand of glory. But what about when he said, don't forget to keep that one safe? That sounded to me like Borgin's got another one of the broken objects, and Malfoy wants both. You reckon? Yeah, I do. Malfoy's father's in Azkaban. Don't you think Malfoy'd like revenge? Malfoy? Revenge? What can he do about it? That's my point. I don't know. But he's up to something, and I think we should take it seriously. His father's a Death Eater, and... Harry, what's wrong? Your scar's not hurting again, is it? He's a Death Eater. He's replaced his father as a Death Eater. Malfoy? He's 16, Harry. You think you know who would let Malfoy join? It seems very unlikely, Harry. What makes you think... In Madam Malkin's. She didn't touch him, but he yelled and jerked his arm away from her when she went to roll up his sleeve. It was his left arm. He's been branded with the dark mark. I'm not sure, Harry. Bill and I have almost decided on only two bridesmaids. Jeannie and Gabrielle will look very...
Ah, Harry!
Good. I wanted to explain about the security arrangements for the journey to Hogwarts tomorrow. We've got ministry cars again, and there will be Aurors waiting at the station. You'd better get on, Harry. I want the trunks ready tonight, if possible, so we don't have the usual last-minute scramble. Mr. Weasley, can I have a quick word?
Of course. Am I about to discover where you, Ron, and Hermione disappeared to while you were supposed to be in the back room of Fred and George's shop?
How did you...
Harry, please. You're talking to the man who raised Fred and George.
Yeah. All right, we weren't in the back room. Well, we followed Draco Malfoy. We used my invisibility cloak.
Did you have any particular reason for doing so, or was it a mere whim?
Because I thought Malfoy was up to something. He went into Borgin and Burke's and started bullying the bloke in there, Borgin, to help him fix something. And he said he wanted Borgin to keep something else for him. He made it sound like it was the same kind of thing that needed fixing, like they were a pair. And there's something else. We saw Malfoy jump about a mile when Madam Malkin tried to touch his left arm. I think he's been branded with the dark mark. I think he's replaced his father as a Death Eater.
Harry, I doubt whether you know who would allow a 16-year-old...
Does anyone really know what you know who would or wouldn't do?
I doubt it, to be honest, Harry. You'd better hurry.
Fancy trying to find a compartment? I can't, Harry. I said I'd meet Dean. See you later.
Hi, Harry. Neville.
Hello, Harry. Luna. Hi, how are you? Let's find seats. Are we still doing DA meetings this year, Harry?
No point now we've got rid of Umbridge, is there?
Wish the lunch trolley would hurry up. I'm starving.
Hi, Neville. Hi, Luna.
Guess what?
Malfoy's not doing prefect duty. He's just sitting in his compartment with the other Slytherins. We saw him when we passed.
What did he do when he saw you?
The usual.
I'm supposed to deliver these to Neville Longbottom and Harry Potter.
Harry, I would be delighted if you would join me for a bite of lunch in Compartment C. Sincerely, Professor H.E.F. Slughorn.
Who's Professor Slughorn?
New teacher.
Well, I suppose we'll have to go, won't we?
Harry McBoy. Good to see you, good to see you. And you must be Mr. Longbottom.
The chosen one, they're calling you now. There have been rumors for years. I remember when, well, after that terrible night, Lily prayed. Good gracious, it's getting dark already. I didn't notice that they'd lit the lamps. You'd better go and change into your robes, all of you. I'm glad that's over. I'll see you two later.
So, Sabine, what did Slughorn want?
Just trying to make up to well-connected people.
Who else had he invited?
McLagan from Gryffindor. Someone else called Belby from Ravenclaw.
Not him, he's a prat.
And Longbottom Potter and that Weasley girl.
What's Longbottom got to interest them? Potter, precious Potter. Obviously he wanted a look at the Chosen One. Well, I pity Slughorn's taste. Maybe he's going a bit senile, Jane. My father always said he was a good wizard in his day. My father used to be a bit of a favorite of his. Slughorn probably hasn't heard I'm on the train, or...
I wouldn't bank on an invitation. He asked me about Knott's father when I first arrived. They used to be old friends, apparently, but when he heard he'd been caught at the ministry, he didn't look happy. Knott didn't give an invitation, did he? I don't think Slughorn's interested in Death Eaters.
Well, who cares what he's interested in? What is he, when you come down to it, just some stupid teacher? I mean, I might not even be at Hogwarts next year. What's it matter to me if some fat old has-been likes me or not? What do you mean you might not be at Hogwarts next year? Do you mean...
him?
Mother wants me to complete my education, but personally I don't see it as that important these days. I mean, think about it. When the Dark Lord takes over, is he going to care how many OWLs or any WTs anyone's got? Of course he isn't. It'll be all about the kind of service he's seen, the level of devotion.
And you think you'll be able to do something for him?
Maybe the job he wants me to do isn't something that you need to be qualified for. I can see Hogwarts. We'd better get our robes on. You go on.
Petrificus Totemus!
I thought so. I heard Goyle's trunk hit you, and I thought I saw something white flash through the air after Zabini came back. You didn't hear anything I care about, Potter. That's from my father. I don't reckon they'll find you till the train's back in London. See you around, Potter. Or not.